this attorney for the husband of the woman who the governor had an affair with. Good morning, Al Watkins.
Good morning. How are you?
We're doing good. First, let's get to the allegation that Roy Temple, head of the Democratic Party, a Democratic operative, paid your client to record his wife and to release those recordings. That's the allegation. What do you say?
I think that is not only hysterical in a sad and pathetic way, it is also very emblematic of the desperation that appears to be front and center in the governor's camp right now.
You were quoted in the paper as saying that Roy Temple helped suppress the story originally. Would you like to explain any further what you meant by that?
Well, sure. In 2016, our firm was engaged because our client had been contacted by a Democratic Party political operative, Roy Temple, who was aware of this story. I was hired to vet out this inquiry. I talked to Mr. Temple. Mr. Temple had the story spot on. This was not a well-kept secret, evidently. When I talked to him, my client's objective was first and foremost in my mind, which was to suppress the story. My client had minor children with his now former spouse. They are co-parenting. And his goal, his objective, was to make sure that the image of my client's former spouse in the eyes of his minor children were not compromised. And so when it was pointed out to Mr. Temple that minor children were involved, and after protracted discussion, Mr. Temple agreed not to run with the story. And to his credit, that was done, some could say, in a fashion which, quite frankly, if he hadn't abided by our request, may have resulted in a different governor sitting in the office right now. So our interaction with Roy Temple was one not as adversaries, but as two parties that had different objectives. Roy's objective was to get this story out there before the election. My client's objective was to suppress the story. And again, to the credit of the Koster campaign and to the credit of Roy Temple, they did not run with it.
So Chris Koster's campaign clearly knew this before the election and did nothing.
That's correct.
All right. Now, a letter surfaced over the weekend from Eric Greitens' wife, Sheena Greitens, in which she said that your client, the ex-husband, cyber-stalked her, sent her emails, sent her letters, tried to contact her parents, went public on Twitter, and then finally secretly recorded the wife so that he could shop the audio to news outlets.
All right, so let's take it all one at a time. First of all, this is not about bashing Mrs. Greitens. And in fact, I will tell you the goal and objective is to, just for the purposes of this discussion and virtually any other discussion, one can rest assured that Mrs. Greitens did not write the letter that appears and is attributed to her. The reality of it is that my client knew nothing of the interaction between Governor Greitens and my client's former spouse. My client had no clue that the governor was tying his wife up, ripping off her clothes, blindfolding her, having his way with her, photographing her. He had no idea until his wife confessed to him. After the confession took place, the infamous confession in March of 2015, remember, this is a man who was deeply in love with his wife. He had children. They were, he thought, happily married. He was decimated. He was literally shattered. And he tried his level best to live true to his vows to his wife. And he did everything that he could to try to reconcile with his wife, not once, but twice. As part of this process, those reconciliation attempts were continued nightmares for my client because of the continuing infusion by the government by the governor into the life of my client and his former spouse. During this period, following the confession, My client legitimately reached out by email in a polite fashion to Mrs. Greitens in an effort to A, alert her of what about what was going on, and B, to enlist her help to put an end to this relationship. The email contact was brief. It involved back and forth maybe three times with a request for her to call him. He provided her with his phone number. She did not call, and that was it. Nothing more. My client has no idea what they're talking about with respect to purportedly contacting her parents. He doesn't know who her parents are and doesn't really care. This isn't about her parents, and it certainly isn't about Mrs. Greitens. It was my client as a man, a married man who was decimated, reaching out to a married woman whose husband was having an affair with my client's wife.
Just so I understand, Al Watkins, you're saying that your client reached out to the governor's wife to try and get her or to tip her off because of the many things, the affair was still going on and he was trying to get her husband to stop it. That's why he reached out to Sheena Greitens.
That's correct. And there was no stalking element to it. There was nothing untoward about it. There were no vulgarities. There were no details mentioned. There was nothing that was mentioned other than reaching out, trying to enlist her help to put an end to a really tragic situation that decimated families and children's and circles of friends.
So when your client reached out, did Sheena Greitens respond by email?
There was response by email, yes.
Are you going to release those emails at any time?
I will be releasing the emails at some point, yes.
Shortly or sometime down the road?
I'm hoping so. Well, there's a deposition of my client today, and the deposition has concluded. I believe it'll be appropriate to get those out. You'll be able to see very clearly that there is absolutely nothing untoward in that email exchange between the parties. It was almost clinically polite.
All right. One more question while I have you here. And that is, she also claims in this letter that was released by the Washington Examiner over the weekend that she this was sort of rumored out there. It was innuendo, I guess, it was on social media. But now she sort of put it into the public domain, in which she says that your client's now ex-wife and her husband did not have a relation while she was in the hospital and giving birth to her son, and there was no physical violence between your client's ex-wife and her husband, and any comments about that is ridiculous. You have any comments on that?
So it's very interesting. Yeah, there was clearly reporting and stories out there that the affair was consummated at its initial stages during a period when purportedly the governor's wife was in the hospital delivering a child. That is not true. In fact, the affair was consummated when the governor's wife was away with her young child, understood to be in Washington, D.C. So the question is, and it's kind of an interesting dynamic here. I mean, what's worse? I mean, having the affair in your home, in your basement, while your wife's away with your child, or having your child? I don't know which is worse, but it's really not for me to say, nor to gauge or assess. But it is correct on the part of this letter that, in fact, the affair occurred at the residence of the governor while the governor's wife was away, but not while she was delivered.
That was one incident. It sounds like that it was an ongoing relationship for months.
It is clear that the relationship was one which was ongoing and unhealthy in a number of respects. So when you listen to the confession that was recorded from March of 2015, there is clearly anguish and angst on the part of the former spouse of the governor. There were also statements thereafter made which are very clearly demonstrative that, and the statements were made by the former spouse of my client, that in a later engagement between the two, the governor actually purportedly inquired of my client's former spouse as to whether she had been with another man since she had been with him, to which it is reported my client's former spouse responded, "Yes, my husband, we are trying to reconcile." And that the response to that, according to the former spouse, was the governor slapped her and called her names that are horrendously vulgar. The types of names that render any man with a daughter or any man with a wife literally shaking like a small dog passing razor blades. It's just not right. So the governor's wife, she's written this letter. No, she didn't write it. She signed the letter. It was submitted. My understanding is the letter was written some 3+ weeks ago. This is all part of a pattern and practice of media manipulation that's designed in an act of abject desperation to try to point the finger away from the governor, who to this day has not bellied all the way up to the bar.
So just
if
so
you're going to belly up to the bar, do it all the way. Don't say, hey, look, we had an affair, but this woman's lying about all the other stuff.
Al Watkins, let me just make sure I understand you correctly. You're saying that your client, who is the ex-husband, you're saying that you have information, or at least you've heard that Eric Reitens physically slapped her or punched her when answering the question, have you been with anybody else?
That is what my client's former spouse has communicated to my client.
Okay. And this was when?
This incident purportedly occurred in July of 2015, months into the relationship.
Got it. What happens today? What are you doing today?
My guess is they're going to put up the big tent and clowns are going to start doing backflips.
What does that mean?
All that's missing is the circus.
because your client is in a deposition today?
Yeah, I mean, anytime you have... Here, and this is really something that's important to note. You know, when you have a rape victim, and that's not what we're dealing with here, but it used to be in the days of yore, before we were introspective and actually thought that victims matter, it used to be that defense counsel would say, well, ma'am, you dressed a certain way. You were asking for it. Or, ma'am, you've had sex before. I mean, you know, come on now. What we're seeing here is, come on, ma'am. Let's call a spade a spade. You had no problems being there. What's the problem? You're undressed. Why can't we take a photograph of you? That appears to be the same mindset that's being employed here. That's what it appears to be, and it's really a pathetic commentary. When here we are, you know, on the eve of the release of the investigative committee's report and during these depositions, that the governor is working with such diligence through his surrogates and through his media personnel and through his lawyers to castigate and to literally slut shame everybody and everyone else, pointing the finger. This is a travesty. We're being scammed. The satanic cult is doing it. George Soros is doing it. The ex-husband is a jilted ex-husband who's a cyber stalker. And to, which makes matters worse and more pathetic for any guy that has any sense of swagger. You're going to use your wife to write a letter? I feels had their own flagger. Hmm. You're going to use your wife? You're going to throw your wife into harm's way? I'm sorry. That's pathetic.
Al Watkins, last question for you. Have you seen any evidence of a picture?
I am not in a position right now to respond to that inquiry. It would not be appropriate.
Al Watkins, you're always welcome here. Thank you for your time.
Thank you.
All right.